horrid and false. Your cunning capture of Numenex Hakon for the ages.
King Olaf was Olaf One-Eye? He famously captured the dragon Numenex and took him to Dragon's Reach. What did we say really happened? I find that highly unlikely, but the court will love it. I'm writing it in.
Olaf grabbed power by promise and threat. From Falkreath to Winterhold, they fell to their knees. But solitude stood strong, Skyrim's truest protectors. Olaf's vengeance was instant, inspired, and wicked.
Strange. According to history, solitude attacked Winterhold, but Asgir seemed to be saying Olaf reacted. What do we say happened? And they got the orders backwards. Ha! Yes, I'm writing that in. It should be good for a laugh from the court. It has a few final lines, but that's all we needed to add. I need to head to court immediately and present this. You should come.
Thank you. I've been working on an original piece. I hope it can stand up to the classics.
I'll be the judge of that. Now back to
I do hope the court likes the verse.
Please address all questions to the steward, Folk Firebeard. Please address all questions to the steward, Folk Firebeard.
I do hope the court likes the verse. I think we've done...
I think my voice is ready. I hope we've done this well.
Ah, Viarmo. I assume you are here to petition for the reinstatement of the Burning of King Olaf festival.
I am, Jarl. I wish to present King Olaf's verse from the Poetic Edda, recovered this very day from the Bard's tomb.
You mentioned something that would convince us the festival should take place, but I didn't expect King Olaf's lost verse. Please proceed.
Oh, Olaf, our subjugator, the one-eyed betrayer. Death-dealing demon and dragon-killing king. Your legend is lies, lurid, and false. Your cunning capture of Numenex, a con for the ages. No shouting match between dragon and man, and no fire or fury did this battle entail. Olaf was Numenex in human form. On moonless nights, he would spread wings and sail. Olaf grabbed power by promise and threat. From Falkreath to Winterhold, they fell to their knees. But solitude stood strong, Skyrim's truest protectors. Olaf's vengeance was instant, inspired, and wicked. Olaf gave orders, Winterhold disguises. An attack on Solitude, total destruction to follow. His men dressed up and then went out to fight, but they reversed Olaf's orders, much to Winterhold's sorrow. So ends the story of Olaf the Liar, a thief and a scoundrel. We of Solitude commit to the fire. In Solitude, bards train for their service. They also gather each year and burn a king who deserves it.
You have proven your point, Viarmo. The festival is truly a celebration of solitude and a condemnation of false kings.
I thank you, and the college thanks you, Jarl.
Furthermore, I believe that such a fine poem deserves some payment of patronage. The college will be generously rewarded.
Oh, thank you yet again. I will make sure our applicant, who was instrumental in recovering the poem, will be well rewarded. The Imperial. Unbelievable! Business is you have done us a great service here. I can't begin to thank you enough. Soon, these things must be done properly. You will be inducted as part of the festival itself. I need you to go speak to Jorn. He was preparing the effigy of King Olaf. Tell him to finish the preparations. The festival is back on!
Please address all questions to the steward, Folk Firebeard.
We should have the festival soon.
Ah, the bard to be. Did Viarmo send you? I'll tell everyone we're ready, but we'll start the festival at dusk. Come talk to me after dark. We'll get the festival started when you do.
I expect to hear your early rendition tomorrow, understand?
Great! Looks like you'll be one of us soon. We'll gather outside the college for the burning of King Olaf.
I'll be the judge of that. Now back to your practice.
There's the man himself.
Thank you so much. The festival has really increased my sales.
Meat pies! Try one for free, come back for more! Get your meat pies!
Spiced wine here. First cup is paid for by the college.
Welcome to Solitude, home of the arts here in Skyrim. May song speed you along. Welcome, people of Solitude! We of the Bard's College are pleased to be here to celebrate the burning of King Olaf. The festival would not have been possible without the dedication and hard work of our latest applicant. With the lighting of the effigy, he becomes a full-fledged member of the Bard's College. Please welcome our newest bard!
Meat pies! Try one for free, come back for more! Get your meat pies!
I think they like you. Yes, congratulations. You are now a full-fledged member of the Bard's College. Due to your adventurous nature, several of the college professors have something. What's more, Elisif has declared the burning of King Olaf should become a weekly event. And finally, there's the matter of the patronage that Elisif wanted me to give you.
Get your meat pies!
mages don't let us go in the college. They said it's not safe in there.
Ranmir beg a drink from you yet? That's gold wasted, friend. He owes this tavern enough coin to burn it down, build it back up, then burn it down again just for laughs. He's had some troubles in his life, but I can't have him drinking here without at least paying back some of the coin he owes. Go right ahead. He just might be sober enough to listen to you. It's not much, but we get by. Very little money passes through Winterhold anymore. But if there's one thing you can count on, it's folks needing a drink now and then. You mean the inn or Winterhold? Suppose it's the same answer either way. Winterhold's fallen on hard times, to say the least. Most folk packed up and left years ago. A few of us are either too stubborn or too crazy to go, so we do our best to make a living. See ya.
I'm just...
Who are you to say what I should do? I'll pay her back when I'm ready.
You're right. What would my forefathers think if they knew I wasn't paying my debts? Tell Haran I'll bring her the gold I owe. Yeah.
We may not have as much to offer as Whiterun or Solitude, but we'll do what we can to make your stay a pleasant one. Thank you. He's not a bad man, just bad with his coins and his drink. My husband Dagger could tell you stories there. I have a couple of Ranmir's things that he traded to us back when he was still paying regularly. I say you've earned them. Good day.
If there's anything you need, just let me know.
Let's sate that appetite, huh?
Back, eh? And how was our friend Kaselmo? I suppose it would be inappropriate of me to ask how you obtained this, so I simply won't. A rubbing, eh? Odd. I expected notes. I understand. Now, let me take a good look at this. Over here, please. This is intriguing, but highly disturbing. It appears that Gallus had suspicions about Mercer Frey's allegiance to the Guild for months. Gallus had begun to uncover what he calls an unduly lavish lifestyle replete with spending vast amounts of gold on personal pleasures.
Does the journal say where this wealth came from?
Yes, Gallus seems certain that Mercer had been removing funds from the Guild's treasury without anyone's knowledge.
Anything else, Enther? Anything about the Nightingales?
Yes, here it is. The last few pages seem to describe the failure of the Nightingale.